And you're ready to flow.
It's worth saying that without this remarkable success, the event wouldn't be happening today. Ahead of us, we have 24 and a half miles of beautiful Suffolk countryside. Of course, daring canoeists see the weir as a challenge. As you can see from the map, the river takes a sharp detour at Pitmire and eventually comes back on itself. This was unsuitable for long 46-foot lighters, and so a bypass channel with two lock gates was constructed to overcome this bend. Because of the lock's remote location, it was built with permanent accommodation. However, the lock would not fill up, and so sluice gates were built to overcome this problem. Pitmire Lock was ideal for swimming, as it was one of the few locks along the river which had a wooden floor. Remaining evidence of the building and lock can still be seen today. Thank you.
The marsh was one of the villages to be bypassed by the newly constructed Stour Valley Railway in 1848.
When the Stour Valley Railway was being laid on March 1st, 1848, employees of the Stour Valley line from the village of the marsh uncovered remains. Buried 14 feet under the earth were the head and tusks of a mammoth, the teeth measuring 10 foot in diameter and the tusks measuring 11 foot. Unfortunately, they broke when being removed.
To continue our journey down the river, we must either go around or down this structure in the river at La Marche. Easier said than done. Build it yourself?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, how long did it take?
3 days.
Oh, wow.
Including watching 3 coats of paint dry.
Oh, wow. And have you perfected the art of rowing on that yet?
I'm not as good as the two people that are up in front.
Oh. We arrived at Bures and could reflect on how the Stour had been used in previous generations.
The first recorded use of the river being used for traffic was in 1628 when King Charles I granted rights for the river to become navigable. Then, in 1705, under the reign of Queen Anne, an Act of Parliament was passed to make the Stour completely navigable. Lighters would carry goods of up to 13 tons up and down the river. The crew consisted of a captain and his horsemen. The journey from here took about 2 days, with an overnight stop at Nayland. From Bures, the main cargo heading downriver towards London would have been bricks, hides, tiles, and malt.